It's an imaginary world, and kids do it with soldiers all the time. You know, it's just I had pennies. I would get the vacuum pieces, you know, the apparatuses, and I'd make believe that that was the submarine. And I'd have my players, the different pennies, assigned to different portions of this plastic submarine, and we'd go on adventures. You know,
this is Kenny Rogers. You have gone. Not the country crooner. This Kenny Rogers is a Brooklynite, a softball player, and my dad. But this Kenny Rogers has a dark secret in his basement. In his cellar, he has 12,000 VHS tapes. 12,000. Imagine that each movie is 2 hours. If you watched 3 movies a day, 7 days a week, 52 weeks of the year, it would take you over 10 years, 24,000 hours of viewing time to finish the collection. What compels a man to purchase and hoard 12,000 VHS tapes in his basement? Let's begin where it all begins. The mother.
My mother, I was like a pet. It was awful. I was just freaking awful. A pet you couldn't get rid of. When I was younger, I thought I hated her. But, you know, I always held out hope. Not so much that she would love me, because that wasn't happening. She just was devoid of feelings. It was the wrong, everything was in reverse. You know, I hated living in that house. It was just wrong. The way that she would punish me is by, when I would go to school or late at night, whenever it might be, she would take my baseball card collection and basically throw them away. And not put them somewhere, but just, I never ever saw a single card after she took them. She would throw them away, knowing that this was the most important possession that I had at the time. This is what she would do. And my mother did the same thing. I had turtles, and my mother would flush them down the toilet. She was a wonderful woman. She could have made my life so much better. So. I mean, she did everything she could to just fuck me, basically. I'm sorry. But she just messed up royally with me. Like, we, Mommy and I, realized that you girls mean everything to us. My mother never had that. Never. My mother would take us to the movies. One day, my mother wasn't pleased that I didn't jump to her her call, and decided that she was going to leave without me. And I was thinking, no way she's going to leave without me. She did. And that stuck with me. So I was seeking a life, any type of life, acceptance, let's say, and it wasn't going to be in my family. It became a social butterfly. I've had quite a few best friends. I remember saying that I wanted to have land that we could all share and enjoy. And I mean, this is at 12, 13. I wanted these guys to be permanent family members of my life. And John was my best friend, arch enemy. And John killed himself. He hung himself when he was 27. And you wouldn't know that growing up, that that was going to happen, but it was a shocker. And it was very sad. My friend Paul Tonies, he grew up in Far Rockaway. He died of AIDS from drug use. That was upsetting. Paul was a great friend. I called him up after not talking to him for a long time, but he had AIDS, and he let me know about it. And his response when I said, "Paul, this is Kenny," is like, "Oh, Kenny, my friend from Florida." And I realized that time has a way of deteriorating friendships, you know, because to me, Paul was always there. Pedro was one of the most loyal friends I've had. He died of lung cancer when he was, I guess, 52. And Pedro, man, he was a rock. Dave Weikstra, who I met at Fredonia, and it just made my whole college experience so much different, because I wasn't away. I was actually in a new home in Western New York. And David died of diabetes-related nonsense at 42. And then there's Bill Darden, you know, wheeling, dealing, black guy. Bill was great. Yeah. I need friends. Friends are very important. And it gets kind of lonely. You get older and all these friends that you have so much history with just aren't there anymore. I sniffed some glue when John Leary and I sniffed glue. And basically, you're depriving your brain of oxygen. And when you start to get high, you're inhaling, and all of a sudden, you kind of lapse into a state of semi-consciousness, where your mind opens up and you have this whole adventure that's there. You know, one time the Virgin Mary, the Blessed Mary, came down to visit us. You know, it's just like all this light, you know, as your brain again is being deprived of oxygen, you know, and it's just, that's what you have in a video or a disc. You know, it's just, it opens up to this whole world. Now, Jefferson Airplane had this concept that all the hippies and enlightened thinkers were someday going to go in a starship and create a better place. And so the starship could have been anywhere, you know. All my friends, all the people that are dead, were in a starship, were just somewhere, going somewhere else. We have the brick fireplace downstairs, something that looks like the size of a VHS box, similar shape or rectangular shape, whereas a brick is a brick. There's nothing there. Each VHS movie that we have enables you to bring your mind into a two-hour setting of anywhere in time, recorded time, in fictional, futuristic, virtual time, any story, any foreign country that you want to go to, any, all these different characters, all these different lives that you can share for that two-hour period. It's amazing. Here you have this world that you can open up. Bill, when I found out, I said, "Bill, you know, put in a good word for me," because, you know, it was pretty obvious that he was going to be dying soon. And he says, "Kenny, I'm saving a spot right next to me for you." And I'm like, cool.
Lather was 30 years old today. They took away all of his toys. His mother sent newspaper clippings to him about his old friends who'd stopped being boys. There was Howard C. Green, just turned 33. His leather chair waits at the bank. And Sergeant Dow Jones, 27 years old, commanding his very own tank. But Lather still finds it a nice thing to do, to lie about nude in the sand, drawing pictures of mountains that look like bumps, and thrashing the air with his hands. But wait, whole Lather's productive.